Here's another quick review activity to summarize the relationship of cellular respiration and photosynthesis. So think about, for each of the following terms, does it apply only to cellular respiration? Does it apply only to photosynthesis? Or does it apply to both? So go ahead and pause this video and just take a minute to think about each one. You can create a simple Venn diagram, or you can just make a list of the ones that are unique to cellular respiration, photosynthesis, and which ones you find in both. Okay, hopefully you've thought about it, and let's look at what the answers might be. So let's just go through this list. A chloroplast, that's going to be a part of photosynthesis. Mitochondria, that's going to be a part of cellular respiration. ATP? ATP is something we find in both cellular respiration and photosynthesis. NADH and FADH, these are the taxicab energy carrier molecules found in cellular respiration. Water, this is a reactant in one, a product in another, but it is part of both processes. Glucose is also part of both processes. G3P, as we've talked about it, it's part of photosynthesis. But in fact, if you look at glycolysis, it is going to be a piece of the first step of cellular respiration. Krebs cycle and Calvin cycle, these sort of sound the same, but Krebs cycle is part of cellular respiration, it's step two, and Calvin cycle, or the light independent reactions, are step two of photosynthesis. Electron transport chains. There are electron transport chains in both the light dependent reactions and in oxidative phosphorylation, so that would be both. ATP synthase. We are building ATP in both cellular respiration and photosynthesis. Of course, we make a lot more in cellular respiration, but we do have this protein in chloroplasts as well. CO2. Again, this is a reactant in one, a product in another, but we find it in both. NADPH, this is the taxicab that is unique to photosynthesis. Fermentation is just a form of cellular respiration where there's no oxygen present, so that would be cellular respiration. Oxygen is going to be, again, a reactant in one, product in another, so that would be both. Pigments, pigments are unique to photosynthesis. Oxidative phosphorylation, using oxygen to build ATP, that's going to be unique to cellular respiration. Electrons, we're moving electrons around in both, just like in our electron transport chain. Glycolysis, this is the first step of cellular respiration, part of fermentation also, but not part of photosynthesis. Pyruvates, pyruvates are also going to be a key part of cellular respiration, intermediate between step one and step two, but not part of photosynthesis. Hopefully this gives you a visual of what is involved in both processes and what is unique to just cellular respiration and just photosynthesis.